Welcome to the discussion on EEOI, that is Energy Efficiency Operating Index of Ships. It is a very important tool in the ship energy efficiency measurements, and we can utilize it to find out how the energy efficiency of for a given ship has changed over time. We have already started our discussion in the previous videos. We have discussed about world global emissions, the ship energy efficiency management plan. We have also looked into the importance of EEDI and the way it is calculated. Today, let us go into the discussion of Energy Efficiency Operation Index. So we already know that every ship is supposed to have a Ship Energy Efficiency Management Plan, SEEMP. This is as per MARPOL Annex 6. So this Energy Efficiency Management Plan is actually a step to reduce the loss of energy, to improve the efficiency of energy utilization happening over ships. And this is achieved by the Energy Efficiency Operating Index measurement. The Energy Efficiency Operational Index was developed by IMO in order to allow ships to monitor the carbon emissions on the shipping activities. The EEOI is the total carbon emissions in a given time period per unit of revenue ton miles. Now, variations in this index are mainly caused by three factors. One is the technical efficiency of ship, second one is the amount of cargo transported per unit time, and the third one is variations in speed. So for a given ship, with time, there can be changes in the efficiency of the ship. When we use the term efficiency for a ship, it can be efficiency of the hull. You know, the hull surface can become rough, the paint film can fade away, the paint can fade at some places and not fade at some other places, so your ship's hull becomes rough. The flow of water does not follow a smooth pattern, so that will definitely increase your resistance, it will increase the fuel usage. The specific fuel consumption, that can be one factor. Rusting can happen, you can also have fouling, so these factors can definitely affect the hull efficiency. And talking about the machinery, we all know that all machines, when we use them over a time, there will be some wear and tear. It can lead to reduction in efficiency or increase in energy losses for that machine. So ship consists of different types of machines: your main engine, auxiliary engine, main compressor, auxiliary compressor, pumps, lot of these devices, lot of other equipments, anchoring, mooring, etc. So there can be cranes also, and with time there can be a reduction in efficiency of these machineries. So the combined effect is what is being mentioned as the technical efficiency of the ship can change. The amount of cargo you carry can vary according to the forces of demand and supply. And speed requirements can also change. You know, sometimes you always opt to move in the design speed. Sometimes you, very rarely, yes, you also move at speeds more than the design speeds. And very often you also prefer to cruise at much lesser speeds for improving your fuel consumption or things like that, or other operation requirements. So all these factors can affect your EEOI. Now, EEOI is a number, and the EEOI, it is actually a monitoring tool. What is the purpose? It is a monitoring tool for managing a given ship's energy efficiency performance over time. See, for a given ship, now today, you know, today I have launched a ship. So this is the energy produced. This is how energy is used in the ship. 1 year from now, will that change? Will the energy produced, will the energy consumed change? Now, energy produced definitely depends on fuel, the main engine, and energy consumed depends on, as we have discussed, the hull, the machinery, and other factors. So definitely with time, these two can change, and that can affect the efficiency performance. So that is something which we need to look upon. So the EEOI actually enables ship operators to measure fuel efficiency. Ultimately, the effect of all these things is on fuel efficiency. If your energy losses are high, it will lead to larger fuel consumption, larger running cost. And if your energy efficiency is good enough or it has improved, it will definitely reduce the fuel consumption, reduce the running cost, reduce the pollution, reduce the impact on environment. So it acts in both ways. And so the EEOI, it enables the ship operators, shipping companies to measure the fuel efficiency for a ship in operation and to gauge the effect of any of these changes in operation. Okay, suppose you know your ship has gone to dry dock and you have decided that by spending millions of dollars you are going to repaint the ship. Okay, now after repainting of course takes a lot of money. After that, has that brought out any advantage? Has it improved the performance of the ship? Suppose you want to measure, you want to know, because you have invested some money, whether that is bringing some benefit to you, you want to know. Then you can compare the EEOI of the ship for a voyage after the dry dock, after the repainting, with the EEOI value of the vessel before the ship was dry docked. So this is enabled. EEOI enables us to measure the value for ships at different time zones, at different time periods. And you know how this can happen? By improved voyage planning. Yes, nowadays we have systems of live weather reports coming to ships, so we can decide, we can change the voyage plan in between the journey. That is today possible. We can also, you know, if we can carry out propeller cleaning, that can definitely help us in lesser fuel consumption. And also, we can also adopt things like waste heat recovery systems, or maybe why not a new type of propeller. So these are some suggestions, some methods by which we can, undergo more energy efficiency, more fuel efficiency, and thereby improve the EEOI value of ships. Now, the Ship Energy Efficiency Management Plan, the SEEMP, it is an operational measure that establishes a mechanism to improve the energy efficiency of ship in a cost-effective manner. The SEEMP also provides an approach for shipping companies to manage ship and fleet efficiency performance over time using, for example, the EEOI indicator. The EEOI enables operators to measure the fuel efficiency in operation to gauge the effect of any changes in operation, like improved voyage planning or more frequent propeller cleaning or introduction of technical measures like waste heat recovery systems or a new propeller. So if suppose you carry out any one of these steps, how that has had an impact on the vessel, we can measure using the EEOI. We can measure and compare using the EEOI tool. So the SEEMP urges the ship owner and the operator at each stage of the plan to consider new technologies and practices when seeking to optimize the performance of ship. Now, a very simple method by which we can, again, as you can see this figure, this is taken from the website Marine Insight. Very simple method to measure EEOI is this formula, where the first factor, sigma FCI, is nothing but the mass of fuel consumed during the voyage. That is multiplied with a CO2 conversion factor. So the amount of the pollution, amount of fuel